Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you how we can draw principal component analysis using SRplot website. So first of all, let me open the SRplot website. As we know that SRplot website is bioinformatics.com.cn. So if you can see, this website is in Chinese. So if you want to get the English version, so you can write /en. So here is the English version of this SRplot website. So to draw principal component analysis, we can simply input our keywords to search any required graph we need. So but before that, you should must log in to this website. But if you have not created your account by yourself, although to create an account on this website is totally free, so I would recommend you to, before using this website, so you can register yourself. But if you don't want to register, so you can simply use this test account using this login and this password. But it would be better if you can create your own login and password by yourself. So as we want to draw PCA analysis, and I have already logged in myself, so I can simply write PCA. So here you can see we have PCA, and if you can see, here are the two different graphs showing the principal component analysis. So the simplest one is this one, so you can simply click on this one, so it will take you to this windows. So here you need to paste your data. So let me show you the files that how you can prepare your data to draw principal component analysis using your own data. So let me start with the simplest data. Here you can see we have the first column, which is the sample, and as you know, we have each sample in three replicates, 1, 2, 3. The first sample is actually the control, and as you know, in most of our treatments we have three replicates. So here we have data of root length, root width, similarly shoot length and shoot width. So you also need to have these column. The first column should be the sample. The second column should be the group name. So here you can see we have one group control. The second group is treatment one. And the third group is actually the treatment three. So this is the simplest design which we often use in our transcriptomic or other studies. So you should must remember that any cell cannot be empty. But if you think you don't have any value of anything, so you can simply write NA. So, but you cannot leave it empty. So it would be better that if each cell has the value. So first of all, I will try with this simplest example. So I can simply copy this all data and go back to this SRplot website, and I can simply paste. Here you can see we have pasted our values, and from here you can see we can select the figure size, and we need to select the font size, and similarly what we need to write as the legend title. So here is the legend title. So we want to write only the group names. Yeah, so the group name is okay. Yeah, here is an important update of this website. You can see which form of data you have pasted, because we have pasted our data in the sample in the rows. So because we did not use the transpose option, so we will be selecting this column because features are in the columns. And do we want to add the label? So like if you want to add the each cell value with the label, so but I don't think there is need. So and if you want to add ellipse, like I mean this outer boundary, if you want to add or not. So if you want to add, you can choose this one, confidence ellipse or convex, but I would recommend you to not do this. So you can also go with the none. So I will simply click on the submit. So here you can see we have actually drawn our principal component analysis, and we can download it in the form of PDF, PNG, SVG or TEF. So let me download it in the form of PNG. So here you can see we have downloaded this in the form of PNG. So now we can directly use this principal component analysis chart in our research article. So now let me show you that how you can arrange your complex data having many treatments. So as in the first example, we have only used 3 replicates, but if you have like 10 treatments of all, here you can see we have 10 for control and similarly 10 for treatment 1. You can see here. So here you can see we have also 10 replicates for treatment 2. So we can also draw our PCA for this one. So we can go back again, control select. We can press control A to select all. We can press delete and simply paste this data. So here you can see it has been pasted, and again we need to select this one. And this time we will use this convex to have a outer boundary. So I can simply click on submit. Yeah, here you can see now we have the outer boundary and we can download it in the form of PDF, PNG or any format we want. So now let me take you to another complex example. Here you can see we can also use our transpose option. So here you can see now we have data in the form of this. So although here you can see the we have written the sample name 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so you can also give the name like S1, S2, S3, S4, it is totally up to you, or you can simply write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is also okay. So here you can see we have 50 replicate of this one, and similarly we have 50 replicates data for this length, width, length and all. So we can simply control this all and we can copy this. We can go back here, we can paste our data here, and this time we need to select. You can see as we have now our data in the form of transpose. Here you can see because our data is transposed, I mean is in this direction, so we will choose this transpose option and we will simply click on this submit button to get our PC analysis. So that's it. You can see our PC analysis is ready, so we can download it and use it in our research article. If you have still any problem in getting the PC analysis, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.